Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk to you about 8 symptoms you should never ignore when you have diabetes. I'm Dr. Amit Ergin, I'm an endocrinologist and a diabetes specialist. These symptoms that we are going to talk today are extremely important not to ignore. And let's get started. Now before we start, make sure you subscribe, make sure you like and share this video, especially if you really do so, because I know you will enjoy this video, and I encourage you to watch until the end because the last symptom that I'm going to talk about is the most important one. So number one is disorientation. So disorientation means like you're basically, you don't feel like yourself. You feel like something is wrong. It may be dizziness, it may be slurred speech, or it may be just looking like this. So if your mother is looking at you like this, maybe she may be having a low blood sugar. So check the blood sugar right now. If somebody doesn't make any sense, or somebody is cursing you, or they're making things up, etc., or they just look like they're not there, provided that they're diabetic, well, that's a problem. That may be, we call this disorientation, and if that's the case, you need to check the blood sugar because low blood sugars can present like that. It doesn't always have to present with shaking, sweating, the classical symptoms we talk about. So disorientation is one of the common things, especially in the elderly. Number two is chest pain. Now, why is chest pain a symptom of diabetes? No, it's not a symptom of diabetes. Although sometimes metformin can cause chest pain or some medications can cause chest pain. But when you have chest pain, you have to be extremely careful. Don't assume that it's your reflux, especially if you have high risk factors. What's the highest risk factor for cardiovascular disease or heart attacks? You guess it right, diabetes. So when you are diabetes, especially if you're a male above 40 and you're a female above 50 with diabetes, and especially if you have risk factors such as high blood pressure, high cholesterol, you are basically a ticking bomb time clock. So basically, you need to pay attention to every chest pain you have, especially if the chest pain is in the middle, it's like a pressure-like, preventing you breathe right, especially if you're moving and the chest pain is worsening. These are the absolute no-nos you have to pay attention to. Now, numbness and tingling on your feet. This is number three. Don't just say that, hey, it's just a little tingly, little numbness. Well, guess what? People come to my office, they first time they see me, they say, oh, it's numbness, little numb, little tingly. And the next thing I know, they lost a toe. Or they get an amputation. I'm like, you just saw me like a couple weeks ago. When did you lose your foot? And they're like, oh, I don't know. I just saw a little hole in the bottom of my feet. By the time I got to the doctor, they said it was in my bone, and boom, the foot is gone. Now, I don't want to scare you guys here, but diabetic neuropathy is not something to ignore. So if you have numbness or tingling, make sure you take care of that. Now, how do you take care of that? You have to make sure you watch, you monitor your feet yourself. It's better to look at the bottom of your feet, if not every day, at least twice a week, three times a week. If you cannot get to your bottom of your feet yourself, have somebody look at it for you. But it's extremely important to monitor. The numbness or tingling is the first sign of not feeling the skin right. And when there is a problem, normally we feel pretty much everything on our skin. And if you're not feeling it, the bacteria will get in there. You will not even have an idea by the time it's to your bone. And that may be detrimental. So when there is a little redness or a little blister, you have to take care of it at that moment. Now, we have an alpha lipoic acid video. I encourage you to watch that right there, and that video will also help you. Don't do it right now. At the end of the video, go to that video and watch that, because alpha lipoic acid is something that's very good. Now, we are coming out with diabetic neuropathy supplement, which will have benfotiamine, which you're familiar with, the alpha lipoic acid, and some other B12 and some other B vitamins that helps the diabetic neuropathy tremendously, which is coming. Stay tuned. The next one is blurry vision. Now, the blurry vision can happen when your blood sugar fluctuates too much, or if your blood sugar comes down from, let's say, 300, 400 down to 100 very quickly within a week or two, you may have blurry vision. A good sign that your numbers are coming down, but sometimes it can be a sign that your diabetic retinopathy is there, and you need to make sure that diabetic retinopathy is taken care of, which is diabetic eye disease. If not, it can cause blindness by causing retinal detachment, by causing all sorts of bleeding into vitreous hemorrhage, etc. So extremely important to see your eye doctor, especially if you're having blurry vision. It is not something to ignore because your eyes are precious. You do not want to give up on your eyes just because you want to ignore a little blurry vision here and there. Number five is urinary problems. If you are urinating too often, or you're not urinating at all, or you're wetting yourself. These are problems that are commonly seen in as a part of diabetic neuropathy. We had a diabetic neuropathy video. You may have watched it. If you haven't done so already, we talk about all sorts of diabetic neuropathy symptoms. So it's there. But the bladder problems, one is overactive bladder, which makes you urinate too often, and you may not even get to the restroom before you let it go. And the other one is overflow incontinence, where your bladder doesn't even work at all. In this case, it's just called overflow, so you're gonna be like basically losing urine without even knowing. So these are signs of diabetic neuropathy. These are also not to ignore, because it can lead to urinary tract infections, sepsis, and so forth. It can get really complicated. So make sure you take care of that early on by controlling your blood sugar and seeing a urologist. Now, number 6 is fruity odor or smell in your breath. Now, more important for type 1 diabetics, but it happens to type 2 diabetics as well. Especially if you're on SGLT2 inhibitors, which are Jardiance, the Farxiga, Invokana, Steglatro. These are the medications that actually increase the risk of diabetic ketoacidosis. But also, if you're insulin deficient, you may increase your chances of diabetic ketoacidosis, which can lead to actually death. So if your blood sugars are high and you are having this fruity odor, you have an abdominal pain, you know, your breathing problems, you're breathing heavily, etc., do not wait. You need to go to the emergency room. Now, what's interesting with this also, if you're on Jardiance or Farxiga or Invokana, etc., you may actually have okay blood sugars and you may still have DKA. So if you have, again, abdominal pain, shortness of breath, fruity odor in your breath, these are the things that you have to pay attention to and not wait before you see your doctor. So go to the emergency room immediately. Number 7 would be the abdominal pain. Now, abdominal pain can be pancreatitis. Again, remember, pancreatitis is common in diabetics regardless of the medication you take, or you may or may not take medication. So pancreatitis is inflammation in the pancreas. So what are the symptoms of pancreatitis? It's severe abdominal pain right in the middle. It's right under your sternum, right above your stomach, in the middle. It feels like somebody is stabbing you, and it goes all the way back to your back. And it also associated with nausea and vomiting most of the time. Some medications slightly increase the risk of pancreatitis, such as your Rybelsus, Ozempic, Trulicity, and Bydureon, and so forth. These are, we call them GLP-1 agonists. Overall, they are great medications, but maybe once in a blue moon, I see occasional patients who end up with pancreatitis shortly after starting these medications. So you have to be careful about the signs of pancreatitis. And again, you don't have to be on any medication. If you have diabetes, you may have pancreatitis at any time. So these are the symptoms, because pancreatitis can develop into a severe, what we call necrotizing pancreatitis, which make you end up in the intensive care unit. And if you do so, 20 to 30% of cases ending up in the intensive care unit end up dying from pancreatitis. So that's another sign that you do not want to ignore. And the last one, the 8th symptom or sign that you should not ignore, and that's the bonus one, is the leg pain. Now, who did not have a leg pain in their life? Everybody gets a leg pain, and most of the time it is ignored. People say, oh, it's in my knee, or it may be whatever, or I walk too long, or whatever. But remember, diabetes is very high risk for peripheral arterial disease. What does that mean? The arteries in your legs can be blocked, and it's extremely common, especially as you get older. And if you have diabetes, if you're a smoker, if you have a high blood pressure, if you have a high cholesterol, I can tell you the 90% chance that you have some sort of arterial disease. Now, what happens when you ignore that? Well, if you develop a sore at the bottom of your feet or anywhere on your leg, it is not going to heal. How can you heal a lesion if you do not have the nutrients and oxygen being carried to that area? So that's why people lose their toes, they lose their foot, even sometimes below knee, etc., because they do not have enough vascular supply. So if you have leg pain, especially when you walk and you start hurting, don't say it's my knee, don't say it's my ankle, whatever. Let the doctors decide. Get your pulse checked. There are certain tests called ankle Breckelin tests, duplex studies, etc., that the doctors can do to identify a blockage in your arteries. So, remember to subscribe, like, and share. We'll see you in the next video. Hey guys, I hope you are enjoying this channel so far, and I hope you subscribed already. If you didn't, do it. And if you did, watch this video right there. I think that will help you too.